Hi everyone, welcome to Excel 2016 Module 3, Formatting a Worksheet. And in this module, we are going to format some values. We're going to work with our font and changing our fonts and font size itself. We're also going to look at some font styles and the different alignments. We'll work with our columns, adjusting the column width. Also working with inserting and deleting columns and deleting and inserting rows. We'll also look at applying colors and patterns and borders. We're going to work with something called conditional formatting and introduce you to that concept and tool. We'll also work with worksheets in terms of renaming them and moving them, and then finally spell checking. So we're going to get started here. We are currently working on, as we mentioned, Module 3. I'm in a student view, so let's go ahead and find our start file. So I'm switching our section. As always, I like to uncheck the exam and training and only keep the projects active. And this is Excel 3, so the file that we want is, the assignment link that we want is Excel 3 textbook project. So I'll go ahead and select that link. I'll choose the start button. I'm going to scroll on up here. Before I hit that download link, that file, it's my start file, I'm going to come right over here and select my file. I'll do a Control C on my keyboard, come back to my start file, go ahead and download that. Remember, I have a default setting of opening up my file in Microsoft Excel, so it is going to open up my file in Excel. Once we get in there, we'll go ahead and save the file. And we can get started. All right, so here's our file. I'm going to go ahead and do a file and save as. I'm going to select the browse button. I always like to save files that I'm currently working on to my desktop. That's just a personal preference. So I'm going to go ahead and select the desktop from the favorites option over there. I'm going to go ahead and select the entire file name, and I'm just going to paste it with the file name that Sam would like me to save this so that I can go into Sam and upload it to the grader to be graded. All right, so our first skill has to do with formatting, and the format of a cell determines how the labels and the values are going to look. So for example, what we wanted our contents to be bold-faced or italicized, or maybe have a dollar sign and commas. So the formatting itself changes only the appearance of the value or the label. It doesn't alter the actual data in any way. And so in order to do that, we simply are just going to click in the cell. So we have our file open. First thing we're going to do is select the range D4 to D32. So I am in D4. And they want D4 to D32, so I'm going to scroll and select this data right here. And they would like me to use an accounting number format button, which is, and I notice I have selected D3, so I'm going to come back and select the correct range. That didn't seem right to me because we were changing the value and that was including that label at the top there. So I needed to redraw the range. So I have selected my range D4 through D32, and I'm going to come up to my number group here, and I'm going to select the accounting number format. So I'm going to go ahead and place the accounting number format and apply it to this range of cells. Next, I want to select the range F4 to H32. So I went F4 to H32. So I'm going to select this range of cells, and I want to go back up to that number group, and this time I want to apply a comma style to that range. So the values in columns E, G, and H will display in this comma style format. And notice that this particular style does not include the dollar sign. We're going to now select the range J4 to J32. Again, we're going to go back up to the number group, and we're going to, this time, actually go to, there is that percentage right here, but we could also click on the number format dialog box there, or actually the drop down box, that's not a dialog box. And notice there is an option in here for percentage. Either way would do the job. We want to increase our decimal. So in our number group, we want to select the option to increase the decimal by one. So we see that the data in our percentage total column is now going to be formatted with a percent sign, and now it has three decimal places. All right, so they show us that we can increase it, but then we're going to go back and actually decrease it. So the decimal place values are removed. Two decimal place values are removed from the percentage value in column J. So we only see one decimal value. Let's now select B4 to B31. So I'll select B4 to B31. And in the number group, we want to select our dialog box launcher. So we're going to click that icon in the bottom right-hand corner. And that's going to open up our format cells dialog box, and notice that the tab for number is active. They would like us to select the format that shows the day of the month, and then the name of the month, and then the year. So we're going to go ahead and select 14-March-12. That is the format that they would like us to change that, because you can tell our current format is the month forward slash day forward slash and a four-digit year. And we're going to be changing that to the day of the month and the month spelled out and then the calendar year. So we'll go ahead and say OK. And that range of data is going to be changed. We're going to select the range C4 to C31, and we're going to apply a different type of date format to this range. This time, there's a shortcut. So if we wanted to get to this format cells dialog box, we could click that button, but there is a shortcut. I can do a right click, and there's an option that says format cells, and that opens up the same exact box. All right, so we just learned a little shortcut there. Here they would like us to show just the day of the month and the name of the month, not the year. So we're going to go and select the type from what we were described. All right, and so it looks like the option that I selected. So I'm going to go ahead and say OK. And that range of cells has been, the dates have been applied differently for that particular range of cells. I'm going to go ahead and save my changes, and we're going to move on to the next task. So the next thing we're going to learn is changing our font and font size. And this really shouldn't be anything new to you. We learned to do this in Microsoft Word. The only thing different is that now we're working in Microsoft Excel. So the same skill, it works exactly the same way. So the font list arrow is in our font group, and we can see all the different fonts that we have. We will have our themed fonts at the top, and any recently used fonts will be here. I don't have any recently used, so I don't have that category. But as I scroll down, they are alphabetical, and I can see the actual style of the font along with the actual name. All right, so we see all this information here. So I want to make sure that I'm currently in cell A1, so I'm going to go ahead and do a control home. Control home will bring me to cell A1, or you can simply click in cell A1. So I'm going to change the font of this to a Times New Roman. So I'm going to come over to my font, theme fonts, and I'm going to scroll down to my T's. It's quite a ways. So I can use the scroll bar, or I can use the wheel on my mouse. And I do a little bit of both. So I selected the Times New Roman. In my font size list arrow in the font group, I'm going to change that size to a size 20. Right? We can also change the size by using the increase font size button. So they ask me to do this twice, so I'll click it once and twice. I'm now going to select the range A3 to J3. These are my labels that I have at the top here. And I'm going to do a right click. This time I'm going to choose, notice I have my mini toolbar is now displayed when I do a right click. And so as you can see here, the mini toolbar, it actually includes the most commonly used formatting tools. So it's really nice for quick formatting. So I just select it and I can access my size, my font, and all the other various tools that are displayed in the mini toolbar. And I can go down and from my list, I can select Times New Roman. So I'm just using my spin wheel and my mouse to get to my T's because I want Times New Roman. And there we go. I'm also going to increase my font to a size 14. So I can either use the drop-down box and select 14, or I can use the increase font size. Either way will work. All right, so let's go ahead and save those changes. So this task should not have been anything unfamiliar to you because we learned how to do this in Microsoft Word. Next thing we want to do is working with our font styles and some of the different options that we have for alignment. So I'm going to go to my home, the top of my document. So I'm going to do a control home. All right, so I'm in cell A1. And I want to bold this. So I'll go up to my font group and I will select bold. And now I'm going to select cell A3. And I would like this to be underlined, so I'll go up to my font group and select the underline tool and italicize. So also underline, italicize, and let's go ahead and also bold it. And then we realize it's a little too much. Maybe we don't want it italicized, so we're going to un-italicize it. So I click the italicize button again. This time now I want to use my Format Painter. Remember we learned about the Format Painter in Microsoft Word. Works exactly the same way in Excel. So I'm going to go ahead and select the Format Painter, and I want to select the range B3 to J3. So I click in cell B3, and I release in J3. So the formatting in cell A3 is copied to the rest of the column labels. And we did that by using our Format Painter. Let's select now the range A1 to H1. And this time we're going to go up to our alignment group and we're going to merge and center. And what this does is it takes all of those cells, A1, B1, C1, D1, E, F, G, and H, and makes them one cell. And it will center the contents of the text into the center of that cell. So that merge and center button creates one cell out of the 8 cells across the row. And then what it does is it centers the text in that newly created merge cell. I'm going to select A3 to J3. So I have A3 to J3. And I'm going to do a right click. And in my toolbar, my mini toolbar up here, I'm going to choose my center option. So we notice that it is a little difficult to read our headings when we center them in there, but we're going to adjust the widths of our column, and that's what we're going to do next. So as we format, we might see that we need to make some adjustments. So there's a few ways that we can change the width of a column or a row. So we're going to take a look at the various ways. So the first way that your text shows you how to do this is to position your mouse over the line between the columns A and B. So as I'm currently in column A, and then here's B. You notice as I hover over that line where they meet, my cursor changes. When my cursor changes to this symbol, I'm going to drag my mouse or my cursor to the right until the column displays TV commercials. So that's one of the entries in my, actually down here. So I can now come back here and I can make it a little bit tighter. Next, we want to position the pointer on the line between columns B and C. And we're going to wait until our mouse turns into this symbol. And now, this time, instead of dragging, I'm going to double-click. So double-clicking, the right edge of a column heading activates that auto-fit feature. And so it automatically resizes the column to accommodate the widest entry in the column. So column B automatically widens to fit the widest entry, which in this column happens to be the label inventory date. So they now instruct us to auto-fit and resize columns C, D, and J. So I can come up between C and D, and again I'll do a double click. There's D, double click, and I'll come to J. Now I want to select my range E5 through H5. Actually, E5 through H5, so let me come in here. There's E5 through H5. And we're going to change, this time we're going to change the width of multiple columns at one time. First, we do this by selecting either the column heading or at least one of the cells in each of the columns. So I've selected the range. Now I want to go up to my Format button, or to the Format button. It's actually in my Cells group. And you'll see that there's an option that says column width. And I select that option. It opens up a box. And now we can type in and specify how many points. So we can specify that we would like this to be 11 points. And we say OK. And now the widths of columns G, E, F, G, and H change to reflect our new settings. So they're wider. Let's go ahead and save those changes. Now we're going to insert and delete some rows and columns. When we modify worksheets, we might realize that we missed some data and maybe we need to insert it, or maybe there's too much information and we're going to delete that, maybe a row or a particular column. And so we're going to learn the different ways that we can insert and delete rows and columns. So I'm going to go to cell A32, so I'll scroll down so I can see cell A32. And I'm going to do a right click actually in cell A32. And there's an option in this right click in my shortcut menu. There's an option that says insert. And what this does is it opens up a box. It doesn't know what I want to insert. So it's asking me, do I want to shift cells to the right or down? Or do I want to enter an entire column and an entire row? And what we would like to do is insert an entire row. So I'm going to select the entire row, and I'm going to see that the contents in row 32 shift down, and now I will have an empty row 32. Let's click in row 27 in the heading area. And this time, I want to get rid of the entire contents of row 27. So I'll go up to the cells group, and there's an option that just says delete, and I'm just going to choose delete, and the rows shift up to remove that. So you must use the delete button or the delete command on the shortcut menu if you want to delete or a row or column. If we actually just hit the delete on our keyboard, it's only going to remove the contents of the row. It's not going to remove the row itself. So whenever we want to remove a row, we need to go up to the home ribbon in the cells group, choose the delete button, or we could do a right click and choose delete from that option as well. Last thing we want to do is go to columns F and H and resize those. So here is column F, do a double click there, and H, and we resize those. All right, let's go ahead and save those changes. Now we are going to apply some colors and patterns and borders. We can use these to enhance the overall appearance of our worksheet and make our information easier to read. You can add these by using the borders, font color, and our fill color buttons, which is located in the font group on the home tab of our ribbon. They're also going to be located on our mini toolbar. All right, so if I did a right click, I'm going to find some options up here as well. So let's go get started. We're going to click in cell A1, and I want to go to my font group and I want to select my fill color option. And as we hover over, notice that there's theme colors and standard colors, and it's asking me to select turquoise accent 2 colors. I'm going to hover over to find the turquoise accent 2, and there it is. And I'm actually in the wrong cell, so let me undo what I just did. I need to be in cell A1. So let me click cell A1 and come back and select turquoise accent 2. I want to right click in cell A1. Notice there's an option again for formatting cells, and this is going to bring up my format cells from the shortcut menu. It's going to bring up the format cells dialog box. This time I want to activate the fill tab, and notice it brings up the color palette. We want to select a pattern style. All right, so notice there's an option that says pattern color and pattern style. They want us to select a 6.25% gray style. So I need to hover over to locate these. There it is. It's the last option in the first row. 6.25% gray. And then I'm going to say OK. And now I see that pattern has been applied to the back of the cell in the background. I want to select in my font group, there is the borders list arrow. We actually want to go to the borders list arrow, and we can see all the different options that we have for borders. So unlike underlining, which is for working with text, borders extend to the width of the actual cell, and they can appear at the bottom, they can appear at the top or either side, or any combination of the four sides. So it may be difficult to see a border when the cell is selected. However, we are going to select a thick bottom border. So there's an option there that says thick bottom border. So when I deselect, I'm now going to see that change. Let's select the range A3 to H3. And in my font color list arrow in the font group, there's my font color. I want to select a blue accent 1 color, and this is in my theme area. And again, I hover over until I find it. I want a blue accent 1, so it's this color right here. I'm going to select J1 to K1. J1 to K1. And my cell styles button in my styles group, I'm going to select I selected the range J1 K1 in my cells styles button. Oh gosh, it's right over here. Here we go. I was looking in the wrong category. We're under styles and we want cell styles. So we come here and they would like us to apply the neutral cell style. So I want to select this effect to that. And then I want to auto fit column J. So the font and the colors change in that particular range. And I'm looking at the text, and it looks like the textbook has the terms sales tax in cell J1, and in K1 they actually have this decimal. So I am actually just going to click this and move it over here. And I'm going to select this range and I'm going to move it over here. And I'm going to go ahead and select that range again and go to Format. Oh, no, I'm sorry. Go to Cell Styles and select Neutral. And I will also save those changes. Now we want to work with what they call conditional formatting. In conditional formatting, so far the formatting that we've done changes the appearance of our data. But we can also use formatting to highlight some important aspects of the data itself. So, and this is referred to as conditional formatting. So I'm going to select the range H4 to H30. And I'm going to go up to the Styles group on my Home tab, and there's an option for conditional formatting. And from here, I want to point to my data bars, and then I want to select light blue data bars. These are blue, light blue data bars. And you'll notice that the data bars are colored horizontal bars. And they visually illustrate the difference between the values in the range of cells. So that live preview that we had there gave us that for shows us exactly what it looks like. So, but we're not going to commit to that light blue. We actually are going to select the green data bars, the ones right above. Let's select F4 to F30. So here's F4. Scroll on down to F30. We're going to go back up to our conditional formatting button. And this time we're going to point to the highlight cells rule. So this rule is a submenu, and this displays choices for creating different formatting conditions. So we can create a rule for values that maybe are greater or less than an actual certain amount. So we are actually going to select the option between. And now what happens is the between dialog box opens because it needs some information from us. And so it's looking for a range. So we need to specify the range. So we are going to say between 2,000 and 4,000. So in the first box, I'm going to change that to 2,000. And I'll select my second range and change that to 4,000. And with the in the width box over here, we would like that to be with a light red fill. So light red fill. Doesn't say anything about the text, just a light red fill. And then I say okay. And I deselect. So anything that falls within that range is being extracted and making it more visible for us to find. Now I'm going to click in cell E7. I'm in cell E7, and we're going to see what happens when I change the value for the quantity from 4 to 3. It now falls in that range. Everything has been updated. And because of the new value, it meets the condition, that we set, it's now highlighted with that light red background. Right, so I'm going to go ahead, save my changes. I'm going to do a control home and move on to the next skill. Now we're going to work with our worksheets in terms of learning how to rename them and move them around. So if you look at the bottom, notice that our sheet is named Sheet 1, and we have Sheet 2 and Sheet 3. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Sheet 2. When I click on Sheet 2, it now becomes my active sheet. And I click on Sheet 1, and I'm now back to Sheet 1. Right, so we're going to double-click on Sheet 2, and when we do that, it actually selects the name of the label, and we're going to rename the label, and we're going to call this Budget. And I hit the Enter key, and now that automatically replaces the default name on the tab. We have up to 31 characters, including spaces and punctuation, in terms of renaming a worksheet. Now we can also change the tab color, so I'm going to go ahead and do a right click, and it brings up a shortcut menu for my tabs, and there's an option in there that says tab color. From my theme colors, I want to select a bright green accent 4 lighter. So let me find my bright green. There it is, bright green accent 4, and there's a percentage. We want a lighter 40%, so I'm going to scroll down to I see there's 80, 60, this should be 40. Bright green accent 4, lighter 40%. All right, now notice it when the tab is activated, it has a gradient fill. So now when I select Sheet 1, we see the full color come into view there. So now I'm going to double click on Sheet 1 tab, and I'm going to rename this one Actual. And I'll hit the Enter key. And I want to change the location of this. I want Budget to be first. I'm going to hold down, notice when I hold down my mouse, I see this little page icon, and I also see that little arrow there. That's showing me where I'm currently at, and I'm just going to move that arrow so it's the first one that we see. So I click here, and then I release. So I drag it to the left of the Actual tab, and then simply release the mouse button. So now I want to click on the Actual Sheet tab. This time I want to select my page layout button, which is right over here on my taskbar, on my status bar, and this opens me up in a page layout view. So if I scroll down to my footer section, in the left hand side, you can place your name here. I want to get out of my footer area, I click in anywhere in the worksheet, and that will deselect the header. We're actually placing our name in the left header, not the left footer, so I'm actually going to go back in there and remove that, and I'm going to scroll now to the top of my document. We're placing our name in the left header. I want to go up to my Page Layout tab. I need to actually get out of my header and footer area, so I click anywhere in my worksheet. So now when I activate my Page Layout tab, I actually have access to my tools up here. I want to go to my orientation because I notice that my page is getting cut off, so I want to change my orientation to Landscape. And that doesn't seem to be fixing. I still have this chopped off over here, so I'm not quite sure. Let me move this guy over. I'm wondering, we may have missed a step, so I'm not quite sure why everything does not fit on a page, but We just made it fit on the page. And so that's okay. The last thing they want us to do is come down here to sheet 3. And if I do a right click on it, there's an option that says delete. It's an empty worksheet. I don't need it. So I'm just simply going to delete. Right, I'll save those changes. I'm going to do a control home, bring me to my top of my document. And I want to actually go back to a normal view. So I'm going to come back over here on my status bar, and I'm going to move on back to my normal view. Last thing we're going to do is check our spelling. Again, this is a task that you learned how to complete in Microsoft Word. So using this tool and should not be unfamiliar to you. It's located on the Review tab, same location as it is located in Microsoft Word. It's in the Proofing group, and it's right here. It's that first tool, so our spell checker. So I'm going to go ahead and select that option. First suggestion that comes up is that we have ads spelled incorrectly, and we're going to accept that change. It then finds the word podcasts. And also, this is spelled incorrectly, so again, we're going to select that change. And we're going to note, it tells us that we're all done, so we'll say OK. I want to work with my finding and replacing. And again, this is a skill that you learned in Microsoft Word. So having already learned it in Microsoft Word, the skill works exactly the same way in Excel as it did in Word. The only difference being now we're in worksheets and not in documents. So we're going to activate our home ribbon. And in our editing group is our find and select. So I select the find that button, and I want to select the replace option, and that brings up a find and replace dialog box. So it gives me an option to find what and then replace it with something else. So in this case, I want to find the word billboard. And for every occurrence of billboard, I would like it to change to sign. And I'll simply say replace all. It'll tell me how many replacements it made. I'll say OK. And I can close out. When I'm done working with the find and replace, I can close that out. All right, so we have actually completed all of our skills for Module 3.